And you're very welcome back at its women's singles once again and nearest the camera. Martina Repiska of Slovakia. Slovakian number one, always a big smile on Martina's face. Against, for me, the unknown English player Tanapat PISITPONG, and certainly just saw her yesterday playing qualification. Two wins over Banerjee and Georgina Bland of England, and I've seen Georgina Bland play in recent years, so Bland certainly an improving player for England. And a PISITPONG can beat her, she certainly must be worth her stuff, so interesting match this. As you can see the order of play again, we've already had two matches under our belts, wins for Wang and Sabrina Jacquet. And this one, the favourite probably Martina Repiska, but certainly wouldn't be surprised if the young English girl came out on top. And then the big one from a Scottish perspective coming up, the Kirsty Gilmour match against Rong Schaefer, formerly Rong Bo of China. No head-to-head, first major tournament for PISITPONG. And Repiska, world rank 78, an improving player from Slovakia. We had Martina in Dublin only 2 weeks ago as part of the European Mixed Team Championship qualification, where Ireland qualified, and of course Scotland qualified out of their group in Czech Republic with relative ease. Alongside me again for this match is Dan Travers. I'm Mark Phelan, and looking forward to your company for the rest of today. Both girls warming up. Don't forget, if you want to contact us, get on Twitter, ask a question, use the hashtag SOGP. And while Repiska, Dan, is the higher ranked player, effectively the English girl nearest the camera, on camera now, is no world ranking. I saw her just play a little bit yesterday, and I fancy her to win this one.
Yeah, I'm sure she's quite good. It's a long way to come if you're not very good. Different playing a tournament in your own backyard for development or something, but to come to the other end of the world.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Did you see?
Right. She's English.
She's English?
Yeah. Still a long way to come up to Scotland.
Well, it's a very long way. It's a very long way, especially if you're walking. But I didn't know she was English. But,
And that's why, I've never seen her before. Uh-huh. You've never seen her before. And I would have expected to see her somewhere before.
Yeah.
So it's a completely new experience for me here.
Service over. One. Love.
You have to go all the way down to the 8th page of the world ranking to find Martina Repiska. Okay, she's got a good start here, 2-0. But her best result was runner-up at the Lagos International Challenge, which is a decent result. Light enough field from that tournament, if I remember correctly.
Service over.
On the European circuit, Estonian International last 16. Beaten in the first round of the Austrian International, so... last 16 of Hungarian International. So very much Martina Repiska is still in the development phase of her career.
I was quite worried there for a moment, Mark, because the England player's first two shots, she served high, the smash came out, she missed the backhand. Changed the racket, received a high serve and hit it about a metre out the side. And I wondered what we were going to get, but I think it might just have been a little bit of nerves.
Yeah,
but she does look to be quite good.
She has the shot. I saw her play yesterday, and you can be guaranteed that grip is tight out there. You know, a lot of nerves.
Service over.
And she'll ease her way into this match.
Five.
She clearly thinks there's a weakness in the backhand side there. That was four strokes in a row played to the backhand side of Repiska.
Service over. Three. Five.
Good variation into the forehand there. Caused the error.
Yeah, nice cross-court smash from Repiska.
Four, five.
Heavily strapped right ankle of the Slovakian. Yeah, poor shot down the, from the forehand side from Repiska.
Five, all.
PISITPONG just easing herself now into this match, leveling it up at 5-all. This shot there, poor from Repiska. Well read, yeah. And the cross court winner.
Six, five.
PISITPONG obviously have tied the scent, and you can even see her when going
seven,
over to accept
five.
The shuttle, you know, that Thai bow and acknowledgement to the umpire. And
that was when I saw her do that. That's why I didn't understand she was an English kid.
Service over.
Not over.
Six,
no,
it
didn't
seven.
Go over. Tried his best.
That was nice deception there, but just too much. Just took
seven,
a fraction
all.
Too late and hit it out the side.
Eight, seven.
Oh yeah, right in the corner, pinpoint accuracy.
Service over. Eight.
She must be
four.
At Loughborough University, is she, Mark? I see that Mike Adams is sitting in the coach's
okay.
chair.
Okay, that's probably the connection. Okay, okay.
Nine.
But she's obviously
eight.
English through and through. You know, born in England and raised in England. She's playing under the English flag, but.
Uh-huh.
But yeah, if Mike is down there, certainly must be a Loughborough connection.
Yeah, and she's up to speed now. You can see she's moving a lot better and quicker than she was at the start of the game.
Over 9-10.
I think that was supposed to be a smash from Martina Repiska, and coming flat above head height. Of PISITPONG certainly wasn't expecting that, I don't think. And the Slovakian ties it up again at 10-all.
Yeah, and that type of stroke just highlights, as long as it's in the court, there's a chance your opponent can make a mistake. So it's much better to hit it in than to hit it out, obviously.
Nice 11, little soft block at the net for the winner, and Repiska, who goes into the interval. With a solitary point advantage, and after a nervy start from the English girl, You know, she's started to settle into this and find her feet. And yeah, looks to have some talent there, Dan.
Yes, and I thought she was going to go on and dominate because she was moving freely, and I think she's a better mover than the other girl. But she's just made some unforced errors, I think, at the wrong time. But I would be, like yourself, surprised if she didn't win this game. But I've been surprised before.
Yeah. Oh, court one. Badminton is full of surprises.
Court one, 20 seconds. Coaches, please.
And Repiska on screen, being coached by a fellow player, her compatriot, Yana Cisnarova.
Ready? 11, 10, play.
That's a wild swing from Repiska.
Service over.
Under
11,
real no pressure.
Ball.
No pressure at all, and it's just not being conscious of where in the court you are. The lift was close to the line, therefore you must strike the shuttle in front of your hand to keep it in or level with your hand, but not behind the hand. Puts it out.
12-11.
I would expect PISITPONG to go on and win from there.
Just something I noticed about Repiska when she switches from the backhand to the forehand side, very, very slow to switch back to the forehand grip. And when the shot comes back really fast at her again, she has this odd grip that she's taking down low and just looks a little bit awkward and snatchy from the elbow.
Service over, 12.
PISITPONG there, I think she's getting a little frustrated and trying to have a laugh to lighten the moment, but she should have had that.
And again, the error from Repiska.
I think Repiska's tactics are to get her turning there. She just crossed her in every shot four times. Error there, trying to play straight.
You can see it in slow motion. Eye completely off the shuttle, almost looking at her opponent while trying to play the shot. Loopy drop from the Slovakian, and then the error at the net.
15, 12.
It's just not getting her way into the stroke there, trying to play to the net. I think the young English girl, if she just keeps pace on the shuttle, the other girl won't cope. I don't think she's got the technique or the skill to, like you were saying, change to cope with the variation, but it's just pace for me.
Over
13-16. Yeah, I definitely think their tactic is to get the young English girl
14,
turning.
16.
To get her turning there. She did in that rally. She does have a very upright stance. And just if she bent her knees a little bit more in her base position, then she would cope better with things going across her.
No, oh, that's a nice straight smash down the line.
Lovely.
Service over, 17-14.
Yeah, That was a very nice shot from Repiska, quite well disguised, I felt.
17.
Once again, that's what I don't think she copes with, anything fast and flat into her backhand side. She's not got a lot of control or feel there.
Decent backhand that time, Dan. But then made stretch to play the cross court net.
19-15.
But it was very good from the English girl. She's got her struggling on the backhand. She plays a nice backhand. She takes it early and makes her cover the full diagonal. And then she's off balance and played a cross out.
Service over. 16-19.
Snatchy smash, but she plays that smash.
Game point.
I'd like to be able to slow it down, but the elbow comes in and she's trying to play this a power smash, but coming from the hip. Mm. No extension or no real follow through and power in the arm. Game point, PISITPONG. Yeah, and that's it again. Poor backhand. That has been the Achilles heel, really, of Martina Repiska in this first game. And certainly PISITPONG identifying that and playing a lot down the backhand side of Repiska. But I think we identified it pretty much from the start that certainly it's the English girl who looks certainly technically better and more comfortable on the court.
Yes, and I would expect her to win after watching that here. I think she'll win in two games. That'll be the kiss of death on her. Me picking a winner. But I think she's got too much. I think the stroke where you were trying to highlight the girl making a mistake, I think she was trying to play the correct stroke, because when PISITPONG goes round the head and she hits anything, she's slow coming out the corner. And if you can hit a quick cross court in there, a cut or a smash or a stick smash, I think she would get dividends from it, but she just played it all wrong and made a mistake. But I think Rapiska's got her work cut out here. They'll need to come up with something very special to win this game, because I just don't see it happening. I think the English girl will secure the victory here.
Second game. Play.
So second game underway, nearest the camera in black for Slovakia, Martina Repiska in red, far side of the net. First point to Tanapat PISITPONG of England. Better from Repiska. Opening up the court.
Service over. 1-1.
Variation. The short serve. The poor backhand. PISITPONG certainly reads well coming forward to the net.
Yeah, and the good thing, which is a good coaching point, is when she hit the shuttle from the net, she's ready. She's looking for it coming back, not assuming she's hit a winner. That was terrible, a terrible mistake there.
Service over.
You can see the frustration. Wide open court. I think it was more difficult to miss. She's active and she wants it, and she, you know, rackets up and she's in there looking.
She's up for it and she's ready, and I just think, I watched the girl Repiska, and she's got a lovely manner about her. She's always smiling, happy, but I think she needs to do a fair bit of work on her movement around the court.
4-2.
She's not short of effort though. She's big heart and putting in everything she can.
Club players that are almost very, very again under no pressure and not even finding the doubles line.
Yeah, and she's very lucky that if you watch again, whenever she puts anything deep into any of the corners, she biases herself in one half of the court. And if the girl just plays anything cross court, she won't get to it.
7-2.
Very simple there in the slow motion. You can see that just a smash and a block to the net, and it's a winner. She's doing well getting to those cross courts, because I didn't think she would get to them.
Yeah, I think she's more mobile than maybe some people give her credit for. And as you said, a big heart.
Yeah, certainly she showed it there, Mark, because I didn't, that was two she picked up quite nicely, but I didn't think she would get to either of them.
Error from PISITPONG, certainly.
4-7.
Open court. Repiska isolated in the deep forehand corner. You'll see it here again. Really should have been a backhand flick for the kill.
5-7.
Yeah, anything, as long as it was in, Mark, was the main thing.
Yeah, anything would have won that rally for sure. Some nice strokes, PISITPONG, but very naive. There's a naivety there.
Yeah, there definitely is. And it's also, you can see the difference in quality of the last two players we had on court. The clears aren't going right into the tram lines. And it's an entirely different game from the last game we were watching. There's no real fluency there in the movement from Repiska. She should be hitting down and looking the court. I'm not saying it's the girl's fault, Mark. It's just she needs help, obviously, to develop her game. And she's not short of heart. I'm sure she would do it if she had the coach working with her with the knowledge. You can see her. She still feels she's in this. Then she's up for the challenge.
Service over. 10-6.
simple winner. Cut. That's a lovely shot. That is a real quality shot that she just lost that rally to.
Yeah, this time no mistake.
No, and just too flat from Repiska there, that lift.
Interval.
And it's PISITPONG who goes to the interval. 5-point lead, 21 minutes gone, and I think this match pretty much going according to as we predicted. The English player taking the first game. And Repiska battling hard, fighting hard, but just lacking that ultimate little bit of quality to play top-class winners. And again, Yana Cisnarova discussing tactics with Martina Repiska.
Court one.
We had them in Dublin only a few weeks ago, and they're all full of smiles. Lost out in the end, finished bottom of the group, Norway finishing above them. Ireland winning the group ahead of Bulgaria. But bad news for Ireland ahead of those championships coming up in February was the injury to Chloe McGee in Hong Kong yesterday. So a huge dent for Ireland.
Is it a bad injury, Mark?
I haven't quite heard. She's flying home to have an MRI scan, but you know, anything that happens with the knee.
Well, I hope it's nothing serious.
No, I hope not, because Chloe is one of those. I suppose who never really suffered much from injury.
11.
And when you know, get that injury for the first time, the physical side of it is one thing, but the mental side of trying to deal with injury, to me, is so difficult. Knee injury stopped my playing career when I was 18 years of age.
7.
Cruciate ligament. Back then, in the old days. The technology wasn't there, you know, to fix it.
Service over, 8-12.
So back with the play.
I think that's her chance, 12. Mark. If she just goes out and tries to attack, because I don't think she's got the skill to handle if PISITPONG is attacking her. But I think that if she was to attack the English girl, I think she may get the errors that she needs. But that'll be a tough challenge for her. Because I do think the English girls get slightly better quality shots, and she'll have to work very, very hard indeed to do it.
Oh, and the poor backhand. And again.
Service over. 13.
PISITPONG reading it very well, anticipating the shuttle coming back short. You see it here. Pushing Repiska down the backhand. All over it at the net, and buried into the floor.
Repiska trying a round the head reverse cross court there and just making a mistake with it. Trying to play too tight, it just needs to be in the court, give yourself a chance. Repiska just lifting out the back there. She should just have played on the net and made PISITPONG move. That's much better that time, and then an unforced error again.
17-9.
Yeah, she was in the rally there and dictating the rally, and then just a poor error letting her down again.
And it is poor, but the difficult thing, and people who don't play the game don't understand, when you're out there, it's very tough, and you're always trying to play tight, and tight to the lines, tight to the net. It's just the margin of error that you allow yourself. The experienced players give it a better margin of error to go in the court, but of course their strokes are much better quality because they've practiced and practiced for years. But the game's just running away from her now.
Yeah, 7 points in a row for the English girl.
You see, and that's what it is there. It's just get them in the deep forehand corner. They hit a cross smash. Make them work. Just plays a simple straight block, and it's enough to win the point.
11 match points for Tanapat PISITPONG. Nice reverse round the head cross court. Soft little net shot in the end, and the humble Thai to her opponent, but in the end, too good for Repiska. 21-16, 21-9 win in just 28 minutes. And PISITPONG winning the last 9 points in a row to comfortably win that second game. A disappointment for Martina Repiska. You can see last rally. Martina Repiska at full stretch. Big smiles from the English girl. And we'll be back next with another women's singles from court one. The big one from a Scottish perspective, and a big test for Kirsty Gilmour, the top seed, against Rong Sheffer, the Chinese-based American who played for 3 or 4 years in Denmark. You can see the schedule there. PISITPONG winning in the third match, and Jacquet victorious over Newell, and Wang beating Fleming Kwok in the very first match we had. We'll take a short break, come back to us shortly with the match between Kirsty Gilmour and Rong Sheffer.